All of you. Today I will be explaining to you data frames in R. So data frames are data displayed in a format as a table, so as a database. You have seen databases where different columns are there, so that's what we call a data frames in R. I'll show you the examples. So I'll cover this many topics on the data frames: create, how to create, and summarize the data, how to access each item, then how to add rows and columns, how to remove rows and columns, and how to find the frame length and combine the data frames. Okay, so the basic explanation is data frames can have different types of data inside it. While the first column can be character, the second and third can be numeric or logical. However, each column should have the same type of data. So this data structure or data frame, the peculiarity is that one column can contain entire thing as strings or suppose name of the students. Next column can have height of the students, so it will be integer or a real number. And a third column can be weight, and it can also be like an integer like that. So that's what a data frame is. So let us work it out and see how it is being done. So this is a command for creating a data frame, data dot frame, and then it the name of the column, training, and then what the contents of that, pulse, the next column, duration, and we use the combine function or C function to combine the elements in that. Okay, so let us see. Okay, so now that is the data frame is made. So let us see what is the data frame. So it contains three columns, three rows, and then these are the elements or items in that. Okay, so how to access the elements in that? Okay, that's the first thing. So data frame, just type dollar sign. Okay, then it will show the name of the columns inside that. So if you select training, it will show you the contents in that. Okay, and suppose we type data underscore frame dollar pulse. Okay, it will show you the elements in the pulse column. Okay, and one more method is there, that underscore frame duration. Okay, it will show you the elements in that. So these are the different methods to access the elements inside that, and you can see the call names of what are the column names and then row names. So row name is 1, 2, 3 is being given. Okay, and then what is the dimension of that, number of columns and number of dimension of that 3 by 3. Okay, and then length. Here length, you have to be little careful. The length of that frame, it shows 3, so there is number of columns it shows. Okay, not the total elements. Okay, so what are the topics now? Yeah, and also summary. So suppose we type summary. Okay, summary is always acts as you know in the Excel. Summary gives the summary of the min max values and all. Okay, let us see summary of data frame. You can see, okay, you can see how many minimum value, maximum value, first quartile, median, mean, third quartile, all these things. Okay, of how the numeric values. Okay, this is how the summary is given. Okay, so let us see the next topic, how to add rows and add columns. So what is our data frame? So now suppose you want to add a column to that. Okay, column, you want to add a column to that. What should be the condition? You have to have a heading for that. Okay, and then heading for that column, and then elements. So it, for the time being, it should have only three elements. Okay, so now let us try that. Okay, that frame cbind column bind data frames. So I'm going to give a name as steps. Okay. I'm going to gain 30, 40, 50. Okay, so in column name is steps, and then I given three values. So let us see now what will be the, you can see steps, one new column has been added and the value of that. Okay, so now suppose you want to add a row to that. Okay, row. So how to add that frame R bind, you are adding a row to that. Okay, R bind that frame, and now there's no need of any row name or anything, it gets automatically added for. So C, you should be careful in that. I'm adding stamina comma 255 50. Okay, right. Okay, so now it is being added. So now if you see what is the contents, now you can see. So here, suppose I'm trying to see, add a new row, and in that I have given this name. Okay, it will show you error because the levels are defined already, so you cannot have anything more than the levels. Levels, because we made a data frame. Let us try once more. Let me see. The first command I'll take, which I showed you. So here I am adding other, and something I'm adding stamina stamina, and then pulse, one more value I'm adding 255. Okay, so now let us see that. Okay, so now this is the initial data frame. So now if I'm trying now the command which got it wrong. Okay, so now here again I added small letter S stamina. Now it will work because already it was defined in that. So now if you see, one more column has been added. Okay, one more row has been added. I hope it is clear to you. So whenever you adding when you're adding a new row, make sure that the levels are maintained. In the sense, suppose you are adding, and now again if I can try here, I will other. Okay, pause. Okay, other. Okay, it will work now. Okay, because it's already been there, that level was already there. So now what is the next topic? So I add rows, add column, and remove rows, remove columns. So same, suppose I want to remove the sixth row. Okay, that frame C minus six, sixth row. Let's see whether just a minute, I'll just recap my W. Yeah, sorry, the minus sign should have come in outside the this thing. So here, okay. So that's it. So minus C data frame minus C. Yeah, minus C. So you are removing the minus sys throw. Okay, that's why. So suppose you are, this is the data frame. Now you want to remove the sys throw, means minus six minus C bracket six comma nothing. Okay, you are just removing the sys throw hello. Okay, this is the thing. Sorry for the confusion. So suppose you want to, again I am taking the data frame, and now you want to remove the fifth and sixth. Okay, fine. Okay, you get this. Okay, suppose you want to remove the sixth row and third column. Okay, minus C. Okay, the duration will go. Okay, so this is the thing. So this is how you remove the column. You can assign this data frame to a new data frame and then take it if you want. Oh, this is how you remove rows and columns. Okay, so minus C and then put the row number, and this is how you get it. So let me see the next topic. So amount of rows and columns, I told you data. So combining data frames. So combining data frames, you should be careful. So you are having two data frames and then you are adding one to another. So you have to be always be careful. So let us try that. Okay, I will show you. I will just try that. Now I'll tell you how to combine two data frames. So I'm having two data frames, data frame one and data frame two. So you can see data frame two contents, and then see, so now data frame one and two are having same number of columns. So you can combine these two data frames using the command rbind. New data frame equal to row bind data frame comma data frame 2. Okay, so it is combined. You can see the new, it is combined. So this is how you combine. So suppose we can try one more. We can add a column and see how to combine. Suppose I had added the one more column to that. Okay, steps. So suppose you are having this one. Okay, now data frame we have 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 columns are there. So now you can see data frame. So four columns are there, 6 rows and four columns. Now if you do that previous command to combine, it will show you error. Okay, so you have to be very careful with that. So now how we can rectify that? We can remove the columns of data frame, one column. Okay, and then you can try C minus C one to four. Okay, it will work. If you remove the fourth column and then if you do it, it will work. Then you can combine. So you have to be very careful with that. Always the number of columns of the combining data frames must be same. So I'm stopping here. So this is the last data structure I had to take for you. So just a recap, we took the vector, matrix, arrays and data frame. Okay, the main data structures I have taken. I am stopping with that. If you got any doubt, you can just comment on my videos. I will explain to you. Hope you understood. Yeah, I have taken all the topics. Thank you.